Hello and welcome to our 9th video in our Mod Tool tutorial series. I'm Dragon and today we're going to talk about peace negotiations, war values and the conditions editor, which is a very important tool when setting up requirements and conditions for various things to happen during the game. So let me start by opening the peace negotiations, and here as you can see we have three types of negotiations: demands, offers and both, so both offers and demands. After selecting one of those types, you can also select Simple Negotiation button, Province Select Negotiation and for other country Province Select Negotiation. And those buttons are pretty important because Simple Negotiations simply apply certain effects to the sender country, the country that is demanding something, and to the receiver country, the country that is accepting the demands. But Province Select Negotiation first allow you to open the Province Select window in the game and select some provinces. So that option here is relevant when you are, for example, trying to annex the province and you are demanding from the receiver country that their provinces start belonging to you. And also you can select this button here for other country provinces select negotiation, and it works similarly to province select negotiations, but first you select your allied country, for example, and then you select provinces which your ally will acquire from those demands. But I'm going to show an example with simple negotiations here. So let me select demands type, simple negotiations, and let me click the add proposition button here. And this is the first proposition on our proposition list. And after clicking it, after selecting it, here we have all the details of this proposition and you can edit it. So let me enter here the name of our proposition, for example, humiliation. Because we are going to try to humiliate our enemy that we have defeated, and we are going to demand from them reducing their score and some other parameters. Let me show how that works. First of all, we can choose which political system is allowed to use this demand. We can, for example, say that democracy is forbidden from using the humiliation peace negotiation. And we can also select how our political parties are treating this proposition. By clicking here the lobby button, far left party would need to be lobbied before agreeing for this proposition. Then we have parameters for our negotiation proposition: the war score curve and other curves, which are basically parameters between our two countries, between the attacking country and the defending country. So in order, for example, to set up the flat war score cost for this humiliation demand, I can go to custom parameters right here above, select the first parameter, type humiliation cost, and by selecting this parameter I can add a base parameter here, base modifier, get percent value and type, for example, 55 and save to modifier. And now this humiliation cost will be equal to 55 war score. And by selecting here the first position of on our list, I can add this humiliation cost with the value of 55 as our war score curve cost, flat cost. So now the attacker would have to reach 55 of war score to be able to demand humiliation from their enemy. And if you hold your left mouse button here on this panel and slide it up, you will see four effects configurators. Each of those buttons open one configurator of effects for one country, for receiver and the sender. The sender of the demand or receiver of the demand. And here you can set up one country effects and two country effects. And if the receiver accepts the demands, those effects will be applied. So for example, let's select here receiver and go to score effect, add it here, and let's input here -1000 forever. And now, after saving, this effect was added here to the receiver effects list. And now if I press this button E here, I will open again the configurator of effects. And this is it, the humiliation demands. After accepting, the defeated country will lose 1000 score points. And that is basically how you set up your peace negotiations. The same methodology applies to offers and above offers and demands. You can also set up here the white peace effects, but it has the default effect of ending the war with white peace, so you can only add here additional effects. You do not need to actually add a white peace effect, which is also a separate effect. But in order to truly use the power of our peace negotiation editor, we need to open the condition setup. In this case, for example, for the sender country. And conditions are a very powerful tool. And here in the peace negotiations, I believe we encounter them for the first time. So after clicking the conditions setup for sender button, a conditions editor opens. And it is divided into three parts. Here on the left, you have the gray canvas area. You cannot scroll it, you cannot move it around. It is fixed in position. And here to the right, you have the node setup and you have the preview window. Let me show you how they work. First of all, what are conditions? Conditions are sentences created with operators and condition nodes, like that, that are checking various parameters with each other, and they are trying to determine whether the whole expression is true. If the whole condition setup window is true, then, for example, in this case, this peace negotiation of humiliation is also true, so it can be used by the player or by AI. If some conditions were not met, the whole humiliation demand would be also false, and therefore it could not be used in this situation. So how to use, how to create, how to set up conditions? First of all, you need to create an operator. You can either add AND node or OR node. Let's go with AND. The first operator that you add in your canvas is your main operator. You cannot delete it. And it is the beginning of your sentence. I recommend sliding it up to the top. And then you can add condition nodes. And here is one simple condition that we're going to edit. And also, you need to left-click on your operator and right-click on your condition to create a connection between them. You can delete the connection by clicking the red square here. You can add it again. And by clicking the condition, or first of all by hovering your mouse over the condition, in the lower right part of the screen, you can see the preview of this condition. But it is not set up yet, so there is nothing there. And by left-clicking the condition, here in the node setup, we can find basic drop-downs that lets you choose the desired condition. Because our humiliation demands reduces the score of our enemy, of our defeated enemy, by 1000, I believe it is especially useful when our own country has low score points. And it is a good way to reduce the enemy score point, and it is a quick way to reduce the enemy score points, and so our country will be more prestigious by comparison. And therefore, I believe that if our country has a lot of score points, this humiliation demands should not be available. So let me go to our condition setup, select the condition, and go to political parameters here. These are our condition categories, and inside those categories, we have various specific conditions. And let me go to the score condition here and select it. And now, this condition here on the canvas is set up as the score condition. And here in this input field, I can set up the condition value. And for example, I would like for my country to be able to send those demands if my country has less than 10,000 score. So let me input here 10,000. And from this dropdown, the comparator type of this condition, let me choose less comparator. And now this condition is set up. The score condition checks whether my sender country has less than 10,000 score points. If it is true, let me save. If it is true that my country has less than 10,000 points, the humiliation peace negotiation will be available for me. If my country has 10,000 score points or more, this whole expression will be false, and the humiliation demands will not be available. So as you can see, conditions are pretty important and pretty powerful tool, because they allow you to check various conditions during the game and determine whether some actions, events, peace negotiations, and various other elements are available for certain countries or certain situations. You can, of course, add more conditions here. For example, I could check also other various political parameters. I can add some other operator here, like OR, and connect it. And I could add two more condition nodes. And now, this condition has to be true, and one of those conditions has to be true, because here is the OR operator, which means only one of those connected lines has to be true for this whole expression to be true. And always the condition setup checks the highest condition, highest operator in the hierarchy. So if this OR is true, because one of those two conditions is true, this AND operator will also be true if also this condition is true. So let me set up here really quick at this condition on the left. Let's go, for example, to also political parameters and check our current militarism condition. And let's, for example, say that I can humiliate other countries only if my militarism is greater or equal to 20. And also let me select the second condition here. And let's say that I can humiliate countries if my current system condition is totalitarian. And here we have a condition that lets you choose something from the dropdown. And in this case, only equal or not equal comparators are doing anything, because either you can be totalitarian state or not. And now this OR operator determines if my country has its militarism condition greater or equal to 20, or if my country is totalitarian state. If either of those is true, the whole expression here is true, and therefore this connection gives me the true result here for our highest in the hierarchy operator. And this condition here, if it's true, if both of those connections are true, then the whole condition setup is true, and therefore my humiliation demands can be visible for my country and can be used in our peace demands. And that is a real quick way to set up your conditions. But of course, you can add more complicated connections. You can add more complicated structure here. And of course, you can also save your conditions. So let me type, for example, here, humiliation conditions. And when I press save conditions here again, this type of conditions was added here to the list. And now I can open another condition setup anywhere in the mod tool and load it to use it again. All right, we have taken a look at our peace negotiations and the quick look at our condition setup. And now let me go to the war values here. And let me talk about them real quick. Here you can set up how much province GDP is affecting the war score. Here you can set up how much province population is affecting the war score. And here you can set up the bonus for the war score by occupying the province if this province is a capital province. And also here you can set up how much winning a theater adds to your war score. So these are various factors that determine how fast a country is gaining war score during the war. And this is important during the peace negotiations, because as I have shown you, various demands or offers can have their war score cost. And that would be it in our video about peace negotiations, war values, and condition setup. Thank you for listening, and see you next time.